What's up, guys? Larry here, aka LCD, and I wanted to give you guys my quick reactions to the Microsoft portion of E3 so far. They just finished their media briefing. It lasted exactly about an hour and a half, as they always tend to do. Usually back in a few years ago, E3 press conferences were only an hour, but now they extended them to an hour and a half. So that's pretty cool. But going into this press conference, or going into E3 in general, I was kind of just not looking forward to it. I didn't want to get my hopes up about anything in case I didn't see what I wanted to see, or there was just, you know, just there was, I wasn't interested in anything, or something didn't surprise me. So going just right off the bat, I'm going to go ahead and give this press conference a 6 out of 10, because from my experiences, and I've been watching E3s for years now, as I'm sure you guys have as well. E3s are getting kind of dull. Like, there's no, they've been using the same format for years and years now, and it's just getting so dull. And I just like to see them spice things up, surprise us more often with things that we weren't expecting and things like that. Going to this press conference, or after the end of this press conference, I saw exactly what I knew we were going to see. And I didn't really see anything that jumped at me as a surprise, except for the one thing that they did announce that I just didn't even know about. So I was definitely surprised by this, was the fact that Xbox One is getting Xbox 360 game compatibility, which is really freaking cool. And they took shots at Sony by saying, we're not going to make you pay for your old games anymore. Because, you know, with Sony's backwards compatibility thing, where it's not really backwards compatibility, they just make you re-download and buy all your old games to your PS4. But with the Xbox 360 compatibility on Xbox One, you can actually play your old retail disc on the Xbox One, as well as re-download them if you had any digital games that you purchased on your 360, which is pretty cool. It's available right now for Xbox Live Preview members, the preview program that they have on Xbox One, but it'll actually be launching live later this year. But again, if you're in the preview program, you can start playing the Xbox 360 games now. Hopefully that update is available right now. But yeah, like, going to this press conference, I was really not looking forward to anything except for a couple of games: Gears 4, Crackdown 3, and of course, Rise of the Tomb Raider. I was looking forward to Kingdom Hearts 3 and Final Fantasy 15, but I'm pretty sure those are going to be in the Sony press conference later tonight. I did get 2 out of my 3 games. I did get Tomb Raider, Rise of the Tomb Raider, and I did get Gears of War 4. But I was disappointed. We didn't see any Crackdown 3 stuff. They showed us a Crackdown 3 teaser trailer last year, so I honestly thought we were actually going to see some Crackdown 3 gameplay this year, but we didn't see anything Crackdown later, which means the game is probably a ways off. Probably we won't see any Crackdown 3 until next year, in which case the game will probably launch late 2016. Now, Rise of the Tomb Raider, that looked absolutely amazing. You guys can check out my reaction video. I have it uploaded for you guys. But that looked amazing. Rise of the Tomb Raider is looking great, because they're kind of getting rid of the quick time events more, but it looks way more cinematic. And that's what I loved about the first game, was that it's all cinematic. There was no like pre-rendered cutscenes. Everything was in-game rendered in-game in the in-game engine. It looked great. It looked shiny. I don't know what was up with the stream quality, but the stream quality looked like it was being streamed at like 480p, 30 frames per second. It would look terrible. And I have the best internet I can possibly get, which is like 100 megabyte download and 12 megabyte upload. So I know it wasn't me. But yeah, the stream quality looked terrible, but nonetheless, the game looked amazing. It looked really shiny. The graphics look updated. I'm just really sad that it's going to be an Xbox One exclusive. I do have an Xbox One, so it's not a problem for me, but I do want to play it on the true PC mustard race experience, because I just bought a brand new GTX 980 Ti, and I'd love to see more PC games take advantage of my new power. You know, I'm a power hungry PC gamer now. I've been a PC gamer for years and years now, but like, I've never had a high end graphics card before. I've always had like the mid level range, you know, but it just feels great to be able to run and play anything I want at ultra settings, 60 FPS. So I want to take advantage of that by having more AAA titles come to PC. And Tomb Raider was one of those games that I absolutely freaking loved. I just beat it again yesterday. Like, I beat it on the PC twice now. I beat it on the Xbox One, the remastered edition, and I beat it on the 360 when it came out on 360. So it's just like, I love Tomb Raider, and I really hope it doesn't stay an Xbox One exclusive for long, because I really would love this game to come to PC, or at least Windows 10 exclusive, you know. So that was pretty cool to see Tomb Raider. It looked great. Like I said, you guys can see my reaction. The other thing was Gears 4. And to be completely honest with you guys, I was excited for Gears 4. Like, I have not been excited about a shooter game since Gears of War 1. And Gears of War 1 is still, to this date, my favorite shooter of all time. And I played shooters competitively nonstop for 10 years straight, which is probably why I'm so sick of them now. Like, I hate shooters right now. I can't get into them. I just don't feel anything for shooting games these days, which is why I haven't played a Call of Duty since Modern Warfare 2. And COD 4 was obviously the best COD of all time. But yeah, I haven't been interested in shooters in a long time, so I'm hoping that this new Gears of War will actually get me back into shooting games, or at least Gears of the series in general, because, like I said, Gears 1 was the greatest of all time. I still love it to this day. And the fact that I'm able to play Gears 1, the Ultimate Edition they announced today, the remastered edition of the original Gears 1. This is not all three Gears games in a collection, guys. This is not like the Halo Master Chief Collection. It's just the one game, Gears of War 1. Remastered in 1080p, 60 frames per second. Also, they're adding all the exclusive content that the Gears of War and PC version had onto this as well. So if you guys didn't know that Gears of War 1 existed on PC, now you do. And they're taking that version had some exclusive content in it. So they're going to take that exclusive content and actually put it in this remastered version for Xbox One, which is pretty cool. I actually played the Gears of War 1 PC version. It was pretty cool. I don't remember what the exclusive content was, but I'm sure they'll explain that if you just go to the Gears of War website or whatever. But yeah, Gears of War 4, the footage, that they actually showed some real gameplay footage of the live demo. And to be honest with you guys, it just looked like another Gears of War game. I didn't see any innovation. And to be quite frank, they've only been working on the game for a year now. So they really haven't had any time to innovate. They've just been basically working on the storyline, the new engine or whatever for Xbox, and that's about it. Like, where have they had time to innovate, you know? So I'm really hoping that the game isn't coming out till holiday of 2016. So I'm really hoping that they have time to actually change it up a little bit and not just make it the same old Gears game, because that's what companies think people want, right? When they reboot franchises or come up with new sequels of old popular games, you know, they always think that people just want more of the same old. Oh my God, Gears 4, I'm going to buy it anyways, right? But that's not the case. Like, we need to see some more innovation for these games. And I didn't really see that. It looked exactly like any other Gears of War game. It was really dark, in a dark setting. They showed off the Lancer, they showed the Nasher, they didn't show any grenades, they showed the Rodeo Run, and that was basically it. And they showed like this new monster type or whatever. It didn't look like a locust, it just looked like some kind of like giant beetle or whatever. That was it. So I'm really hoping that I'm not disappointed with Gears 4. I really hope that it's just not more of the same old Gears. To be honest with you, I think Gears of War 1 was a perfect game, and then they started getting all crazy with it. So that if they don't go crazy with it and just start adding a bunch of crap, all these 200 weapons, like, I don't need all that. I just want a simple Gears of War game, you know? So hopefully that doesn't disappoint me. And again, no Crackdown 3, so I was really looking forward to that, but that's about it. Other than things that I lined out in this video, I really wasn't impressed with the conference at all. I was only looking forward to those three games. I only got two out of the three. But everything else just didn't, there was no like brand new IPs that shocked me. They had showed like a couple of new IPs that are like Windows 10 and Xbox One crossplay exclusives or whatever, but like Gigantic we saw last year, so that wasn't anything new. They just showed this game called Incore or something like that, or iCore, and that was the new Windows 10 and Xbox exclusive new IP. But that was basically it. There was like basically new IPs. They showed a bunch of indie games that we saw basically for 2 years straight now, and you know, that was basically it. So that was the entire E3 press conference wrapped up in a nutshell. Like I said, 6 out of 10. I'm not really looking forward to the Nintendo press conference like at all. There's really nothing Nintendo can show me that I'll be interested in. I already have Splatoon, I already have Smash, and that's pretty much it. Not looking forward to the new Zelda at all. If they show a new Metroid, don't care. I haven't been a Nintendo guy since the GameCube and Luigi's Mansion and stuff like that. So no interest for me in Nintendo. But Sony, however, I am looking forward to them. They're obviously going to show some Uncharted. They're going to show some They're going to show Uncharted, Kingdom Hearts 3, and Final Fantasy 15. Those are the three games that I'm curious about. So I have to watch the Sony press conference. But I really don't think Sony has anything they can do after what Microsoft did with them, the backwards compatibility. That basically just killed PS4 right off the bat for a lot of people. So I think that was kind of funny. Because especially when Microsoft showed threw shots and said, you don't have to pay for your old games. Oh my God, that was great. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed my little overview of the Microsoft press conference. I'll do the same thing for the Sony press conference. Don't care about Nintendo, so you won't see one from me. And then, of course, I'll do like the same thing I did with the Microsoft press conference and post a couple of my reaction highlights up on YouTube. I hope you guys enjoyed this format. Let me know what you all thought of the press conference in the comment section below. I will make sure to reply back if I see anything interesting, and I'll be read through every comment. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys soon.